Play is the highest form of research, said Albert Einstein. At Science at Home, we take this seriously. We are hard at work, playing. The toys we use are atoms and lasers. Our playground is the laboratory where we are building a quantum computer. So, what is a quantum computer? Let's first consider regular computers that take instructions as bits. A single bit is either 0 or 1, and all numbers and letters can be expressed as strings of bits. To do computations, bit strings enter a processor. In the processor, operations are performed on the bit string to give the output of the calculation. And everything that happens in a computer works like this. The problem is, when calculations get complicated, bit strings get huge. It means that computers struggle with their memory, and that some calculations can take years to do. In a quantum computer, a single atom is used to replace a single bit. Atoms are quantum objects, and when they are used as bits, something unusual happens. A quantum bit can be 0 and 1 at the same time. This means that our input string of bits can represent 2 and 5 and 7 all at the same time. When these quantum strings enter the processor, it does all possible operations simultaneously. That's like getting many calculations for the price of one. The ability to compress information and do many computations at the same time makes quantum computers immensely fast and powerful. So this is how a quantum computer works. But what does it look like? The atoms that we use as quantum bits are pretty playful, and they like to run all over the place. To use them as bits, their movement needs to be slowed down, so we cool them to extremely cold temperatures. They are then trapped by shining a laser on them. The laser creates an energy valley, and the cold atom rolls to the bottom of it. To trap many atoms like this, we create something like an egg tray of energy wells. The atoms can now form quantum bit strings, and our quantum computer is ready to start calculating. We need to let the atoms interact by bringing them together. An atom is moved around with a device called optical tweezers. This is a laser placed over the atom, with the intensity of the laser increased to make the energy well deeper. With the atom tightly trapped, it can be moved around. Because the atom has such a hard time sitting still, it's actually more accurate to describe it as a wave. The crest of the wave indicates the point where we most likely find the atom, while the tails of the wave describe other possible locations. When we move the optical tweezers, the wave starts to slosh around. Move the tweezers too fast, and the wave goes all over the place. If we then try to locate the atom, we don't really know where to find it. To figure out how to best move the atom, we decided to play a game with it. We made a game out of the task of moving an atom. The player moves the well in which the atom is trapped. Moving the mouse downwards makes the well deeper. Moving the mouse left and right moves the well left and right. The atom in the game behaves exactly like a real atom in the lab. This means that a player is actually solving a quantum physics problem. One game play means one attempt to move the atom, and whenever a player finishes the game, we save the path in our database. When a player finds a particularly smart way to move the atom, we can retrieve the path and feed it into the controllers of the real optical tweezers. This will then transport the real atom in the exact smart way the player transported the atom in the game. Now we can do the operations and calculations we were previously missing. This is how your play becomes our research, and how you can help us build a quantum computer by doing science at home.